أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Respect brothers, الحمد لله we just finished صلاة الفجر الجماعة. Asking الله سبحانه وتعالى to accept our salah, to accept our عبادة يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the Holy Quran وجعلنا من الماء كل شيء حي. الله عز وجل created for us the water. And every day you are using water, drinking, cleaning, taking bath, making wudu. But sometimes when we get used to something we did not understand and we did not even think about its importance. We have to know that how the Quran declared that it's very important. We cannot live more than 3 days without water. Yes, that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla did not give this water to anybody. It's very important for your salah. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith لا يقبل الله صلاة أحدكم إذا أحدث حتى يتوضأ. Yes, there is no salah without ablution, without wudu. And that wudu, you need water to make it. Or also, if you have الحدث الأكبر الجنابة, you have to take shower or bath. And the الماء or the water to purify your spirit, روح, and your physically your body. And سبحان الله, الله سبحان رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, الطهور شطر الإيمان. Cleanliness or purification, it's half of your iman, your faith. Very important. That's why Muslims, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, when you cleanse yourself and your body, and when you make wudu, you take shower, you're ready, you will be ready for your salah, spiritually حتى كمان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you energy and take the filth of الشيطان away from you. ويذهب عنكم رجز الشيطان. That's why it's very important to know the importance of the water when you purify yourself from all this filthy stuff. With water also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you tranquility and the sakina. When you will be ready for the salah, your nafs will have that tranquility and the khushu' and you will focus in your ibadah. First of all, when you make wudu, as you know, alhamdulillah, we know all of that, how to make wudu. First of all, التسمية. Say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim before you start your wudu. And the tertib, you have to make your wudu in order. Like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith of Uthman ibn Affan. It's an authentic hadith. You have to know how to make wudu properly, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do. You wash your hands, your face, and what's in your face, your mouth, your nose, and all of that. And wipe your hair and also your foot. Water is very important for, as we said, for the purification of your body. And water itself, it's a shifa too. Remember, Prophet Job, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after his sickness, 18 years, he said, أركض برجلك هذا مغتسل بارد وشراب. Strike the ground with your foot, and you're going to get مغتسل, that cold water, take shower, and drink from this water, Allah will give you shifa. That's why you have to know, you have to understand the importance of water. Sahaba, when they were in the Battle of Badr, Allah sent rain and they make them sleep to take the filth of shaitan, the reach of shaitan, the doubt, the fear, and all of that from them. That's why very important, brothers, subhanAllah, especially the rain, the water of the rain. When you, this is real ma'an tahura, Allah described it. And the water of the ocean too. هو الطهور ماؤه والحل ميتته. You can eat from its meat, the ocean, and the tahur, its water is tahur. You can make wudu from, take bath in the ocean too. This is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith. Very important to understand the importance of the water by making wudu, taking ghusl. And water in Islam hold the great importance. Wudu is not merely, it's a, subhanAllah, a ritual, but an act of worship also that enhances physical and spiritual purity and is يعني, very important for the prayer, like what I just said. Also, subhanAllah, purification is very important, as I said, in Islam, inside and outside. Outside, by taking shower every time, making wudu 5 times a day, and even, subhanAllah, your sin will go away from your wudu. Rasulullah said that with your limbs, when you make wudu, with the last drop going away from that. So some scholars said, don't wipe your body when you make wudu. Just cleanse yourself like this. With the last drop of your, the water is going from your area, just your sin is going out, subhanAllah, away from you. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it for us day and night. And the importance of the water also, subhanAllah, as I said, this is importance not just for the human, for the animals, for the plants, for the vegetation, for the earth. It's, subhanAllah, yuhyi Allah al-arda ba'da mawtih. That's why very important to know that the importance of the water. When you make wudu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam declared it for us that when you finish your wudu, you say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم اجعلني من التوابين واجعلني من المتطهرين. Oh Allah, make me amongst those who are توابين, those who are repenting to you, and those who are purifying themselves. المتطهرين, those who are pure people. And when you say that after your wudu, ablution, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تفتح لك أبواب الجنة الثمانية. The eight gates of Jannah will be open for you. How many times a day? How many times? Five times a day. Means that the angels of these doors, they know you. Your doors will be open for you five times a day. So don't be surprised when you go to Jannah and you will see these angels waiting for you there. Yes, because the Quran said that. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى جَنَّةِ زُمَرَةً حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ إِهْ. بس this is the point. سلام عليكم طيبتم. You're being purified. أيوة. الدنيا used to purify your body, your soul, وضوء and your غسل and all of that. And you are طيب. Now you are qualified. You are a good fit for Jannah. Nobody cannot enter Jannah. No one can enter Jannah while he still has some filth. That's why طيبتم. You're being purified. فادخلوها خالدين. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا رب أن يجعلني وإياكم من أهل الجنة. اجعلني وإياكم من المتطهرين, من التوابين, من المستغفرين, من المحسنين يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا وارحمنا واسترنا واجبرنا وعافنا واهدنا يا أرحم الراحمين. انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. أعلي بفضلك كلمتي الحق وكلمة الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين, في غزة وفلسطين وفي كل مكان فيه مسلم مستضعف. انصره يا رب العالمين, كن معه يا أرحم الراحمين. واصرف عنا رجز الشياطين يا أرحم الراحمين من الإنس والجن يا رب العالمين. واحفظنا جميعا من بين أدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا, واجعلنا لك يا ربنا من الشاكرين. نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وأجله, ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وأجله يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.